CMS versus Fisher football, the Falcons have won 20 out of 22 meetings, and that's really dominating. And we'll soon have an interview with the head coach, and looks like our sideline reporter, sponsored by Greg Brooker. See Greg for crop insurance. He represents a number of companies where you can get the best deals.
Guys, these two it looks like Ryan grabbed here. We're all over the field tonight.
Who's he got? He's got
Freehill, Luke Freehill and Jared Trantina.
Okay, let's go down to Ryan Ferguson.
Hey, guys, we're going to start with Luke Freehill. Luke, first touchdown of the season, man. How did it feel?
It felt great.
Now, obviously, they came in with the option attack. Our ends did a really good job of kind of pretty much crushing that. 3 yards is all they had in the first half. How much easier, now, with them running the option, what is your main responsibility at middle linebacker, kind of watching the play develop?
I got to make sure I get the quarterback from the inside. But I think our outside backers, Jared, he did a great job on that when it came his way. Austin Spiller had a great hit on an option they tried to run on the quarter or when he pitched it. So, I mean, overall, the guys did great on that.
Awesome. Now, last question I have for you is, defense gives up the 6 points there. The backup defense, how much trouble are they in come film day?
It's just one TRS for every point we give up. So, yeah, I mean, nobody wants to see it happen, but every now and then it will. So, just keep playing.
All right. Can't thanks, Luke. Appreciate it.
I already did it.
Thank you, man. All right, Jared, opening kickoff taken back to the house. The initial kick, though, went out of bounds, elected to the re-kick. Were you thinking after that first one dribbled kind of short, like, hey, man, this might be a good opportunity for me?
Yeah, I knew they were going to come back to that. We've been watching their film, and they've just been kicking it short like that.
Okay, and then offensively, they were a lot quicker, smaller, of course, than Paxton, but a lot more speed. How did that affect you as the fullback blocking those maybe a little quicker guys than last week?
They were small, but they hit hard, and I think we did really good against them.
Okay, and then EPG next week, definitely going to be a team that is a lot bigger than what you saw tonight. But you get a little extra day off tomorrow, I heard, for the 3-day weekend. So where do you guys have to get your mind heading into that big matchup, first road game of the year?
It's definitely going to be a lot tougher competition, so we're going to get focused, watch your film, be ready for that game.
Awesome. Thank you, Jared. Appreciate it. I think that's all I got, guys. I don't know where Coach Allen went. He's
okay.
Hiding from me.
Well, if you can find him, bring him on. Right now, let's go to our stat man, final numbers, Steve Sayards.
All right, guys. For GCMS, we ended with, 11 first downs. Mitch McNutt rushing had 11 carries, 124 yards, and 2 touchdowns. Jared Trantina had 8 carries for 26 yards. Brooke Schmidt had 2 carries for 39 yards. Nathan Gerard, 1 carry for negative 1 yard. Lance Livingston, 2 carries for 4 yards. Peyton Keene had 3 carries for 0 yards. Daniel Jones had 3 carries for 3 yards. And Cade Elliott, 1 carry for negative 4 yards. Passing, Nathan Gerard was 5 out of 6 for 57 yards, 1 touchdown. And I don't know if I said Mitch McNutt did have 2 rushing touchdowns also. Brooke Schmidt had 4 catches for 41 yards and a TD. And Rylan Holt had 1 catch for 11 yards and a TD. And Brooks did not have a – yes, he did. Have
yeah, he had a touchdown.
Yeah, he did. Sorry. We had 7 penalties for 65 yards. We had 2 turnovers. They were both fumbles. Ben Freehill added 6 extra points tonight. Our totals are rushing 191 yards, passing 57 yards, for a grand total of, let me do my math real quick, 148 yards, looks like. 248 yards total.
You know, guys,
did you remember to carry the 3, Steve?
Yeah. You know, guys, for scoring that many points, it's not a ton of yardage, but we didn't run that many plays. I mean, and you scored a couple touchdowns.
Well, you had some
special teams.
Yeah, and that's what I was going to say, too. It's one of those things. It's nice to have a team like this, but it's tough on some of the quote-unquote star players because they could really have some record-breaking seasons. But this is the way to do it.
Coach Allen's doing it the right way. Yeah, spread the wealth.
Yeah, yeah. For Fisher, Cade Thomas had let me start with first downs. They had just 3 first downs. Cade Thomas had 11 carries, 38 yards. Jaden Jones-Watkins had 15 carries for 43 yards and a touchdown. Colby Dua had 4 carries for negative 9 yards. Dakota Matthews, 3 carries for 11 yards. Passing, Cade Thomas was 2 out of 5 for 7 yards. Jaden Jones-Watkins had one catch for negative 1 yard, and Dakota Matthews had one catch for 8 yards. They ended with 8 penalties for 75 yards. They also had one turnover. It was a fumble. They ended with their totals being rushing 72 yards, passing for 7 yards, for a grand total of 79 offensive yards.
And guys, I think a lot of those yards came late in the fourth quarter.
Yeah.
So, boy, what a job by the defense tonight.
Yeah, yeah. So you like those new stat sheets, Steve?
Yeah, this is much better than last week. Thank you.
Okay. A lot easier to read.
Steve woke up in a cold sweat 3 times this week thinking about those stat sheets from last week.